Hello and welcome. My name is Debbie Pendergrast. I'm Business Development Manager here at Keencut and I will be your host for today's session. Joining me in the studio today is my producer Curtis.
Hi guys, so I'm Curtis. I'll be in charge of sound and visuals for today's session. So if there are any problems at all on that front, do let us know in the chat function. Regarding the chat function, make sure you are signed into YouTube to allow yourself to put any messages in there. And any questions, whether it's questions on what we're talking about today or just questions on Keencut or Keencut products in general, just throw them in there and me and Debbie can answer those. Do be aware though, there is about a 7 to 10 second delay on those questions between us and the stream. So do be aware of that when you are putting those in. But apart from that, hopefully everything goes well and hopefully you have a good session.
Thank you, Curtis. Brilliant. So today's session, I will be taking you through the steps on how to make a basic sign tray that will end up looking like this. And in order to do that, you will be requiring a few things. And they are a pair of compression shears. You'll need a marker, a ruler, activator, super glue. You will need four clamps and you will need a Keencut V-grooving tool. Now the Keencut V-grooving tool is an optional extra for the Keencut SteelTrak. So it goes on the SteelTrak and this will help you make the grooves in the board to do the sign tray. You will also be requiring a pre-cut piece of aluminium composite panelling. You may know this as die bond or alu panel. I'm going to be referring to this as ACP throughout the session to make things easier. And you will also be requiring some ACP offcuts. Now, if you do have any offcuts and you're making a sign tray, please keep hold of these. They are very useful to reinforce the corners of your sign tray. If there are any questions going through the session, please do let Curtis know and we will address those as we are going along. I'm going to be using today a V-grooving tool number 3, and the number actually corresponds with the thickness of the board that I'm going to be V-grooving. So 3mm board, ACP board, is the most common. So I'm going to be using a 3mm board with a number 3 V-grooving tool. Now, I have had to pre-cut my ACP. I'm wanting to have a final piece, a sign tray of about 50 centimetres in width by 25 centimetres in depth. And I have just got the diagram here to show you how I have come to that piece of ACP that I've pre-cut. So it needs to be dimension-wise larger than the 25 by 50. I need to take into consideration the 5 mm of a border, the 5 centimetre, I'm sorry, of a border for the V-groove so that I can then fold it down and I can get those edges to mount the sign tray onto the wall. So I need a piece of ACP that's actually 60 by 35. The purple border around the board is actually a 1 centimetre border. And this is to take into consideration the 1 centimetre offset of the V-grooving tool to the line of cut on the Keencut SteelTrak. Now the V-grooving tool goes in place of the twin wheel cutter, which is situated here. I've removed the twin wheel cutter. I've housed the V-grooving tool already in its place. This V-grooving tool is good to go. It's already calibrated. You will need to do that before you use it. If you need to know how to calibrate it, I did a video on that 2 weeks ago, so you can have a look at that and make sure you've calibrated it and it's ready to use before you start this. I think we have a link, possibly, Curtis?
Yeah, I'll put that in the chat for you guys. There it is for you.
Okay, perfect, thank you. So once we have our V-groove installed, as on the Keencut SteelTrak, there's a plastic strip, and the plastic strip is called a sightline strip, and it shows exactly where the blade will be cutting. So this is your line of cut. When you house the V-grooving tool on the SteelTrak, it's actually offset to the left by about a centimetre. So as I want a 5 centimetre border for my V-groover, and it's offset by another centimetre, I have to set my production stop down here at the bottom to 6 centimetres to take all that into consideration. Now my production stop on the left does not move at all. So that will remain in place and I can start to V-groove my board. So I'm placing my V-groover, I'm placing my board, my ACP behind the clamp, making sure it's flat on the squaring arm. I'm going to take the production stop on the right hand side and firmly push it up against the board. So my board is not moving side to side, so there's no side to side movement. I can now clamp my board in place and start to V-groove. V-grooving is a little bit more challenging than cutting the board because you're taking out a piece of material rather than actually just cutting the board in place. Remove my production stop on the right, unclamp the board, slide it out, bring the head back to the centre of the machine, turn my board around, again make sure it's flat on the squaring arm, reset my production stop on the right, clamp it firmly into place, and I can perform another V-groove. Now I have to V-groove all the rest of the edges, and I'm not going to do that now because that's really easy, so I have a board I have prepared earlier, which is this one. So as you can see, we have the V-grooving edges all the way around the board. Now what I need to do is I need to cut out the corners. I need to mark them first. What I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be cutting out the corners on the length of the board, because when it's all folded together, the joins will be at the top and at the bottom once it's mounted onto the wall, so you won't be able to see the joins. I now need to draw some lines on my board for the corners so I know where I need to cut out. So I'm going to take my marker, I'm going to take my ruler. I think Curtis is going to pop over and bring this other camera closer so we can see what I'm doing. Thank you, Curtis.
No problem.
So I need to draw. I'll just wait a little moment. All in focus. Thank you for that. Thank you. So I need to draw a line from the centre of the V groove that I've made here down to the corner of the board, so I know where I'm going to be cutting. Now I know that the dimension from the end of the V groove to the corner of the board is 5 centimetres, and I need to mirror that 5 centimetres on the other side. So I'm measuring from the end of this V-groove to the outer edge of 5 centimetres, putting a mark here, and again drawing to the centre of that V-groove. Now I've done that in this corner. I need to replicate that in all of the other 3 corners, so I'm going to go ahead and continue doing that, and I'm going to pass you back to Curtis.
Brilliant. So I just wanted to go over our social media channels and wonder if you've checked them out yet. So we're currently active on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook and LinkedIn, and we're constantly posting to keep you guys up to date with all things new and all the dates of these live events. We're also active on YouTube. The Keencut YouTube channel has loads of content, including instructional videos, material tests, recorded live streams and customer reviews and workshops. So whenever you visit our YouTube channels or any of our social media channels, please remember to give us a follow and a subscribe so you don't miss out on any of these updates.
Thank you, Curtis. Are there any questions yet?
We don't have any questions at the moment coming in.
Right, well, I am continuing to do these lines.
But remember, guys, if you do have any questions or you want to see anything again or any more detail on anything, just pop them in the chat and we can get to those questions straight away.
Right, so I now have my lines on my board, as you can see here. So this, it gives me an indication of exactly where I need to be cutting out. So you have to make sure that the cut lines are on the same side, otherwise you're going to confuse yourself, as I almost did. Taking my compression shears, so my compression shears are effectively, they're like a pair of scissors, but they have more force behind them. So instead of just being able to cut cardboard and paper, these will actually give you the ability with a little bit of force to go through ACP. Now I know exactly where I need to be cutting out because I have already marked my V. So with a little bit of precision, I am lining up my shears to go through the board, the line of cut on that side. I need to replicate the same movement on the other side and the same cut. Which enables me to remove my V corner. So I now have my V that's removed out of there. That also needs to be replicated on all of the corners. And once that is done, you will end up with a board looking like this. So all the corners have been cut out. Now the next step is to actually take the board and glue the corners together. So if we could just come back to this camera here, I need to fold up the corners. Let's do this one. We'll do this one over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold the corner here. I need a piece of my offcut. I need my activation spray and my super glue. So holding it in place, I'm just going to do a little bit of activation spray. I'm going to put some super glue on my offcut. Prepare one of the clamps, making sure I don't super glue my fingers to the board itself, holding everything in place. Now with my clamp down firmly, that will hold that in place. And I need to continue gluing all the rest of the corners. So I'm going to continue gluing the rest of the corners and I will leave you again with Curtis.
Brilliant. So I just want to touch on our live streams that we're doing at the moment and these sessions. So we do have more sessions lined up and on scheduled already. So these sessions include how to disengage the ratchet and score and snap acrylic on the SteelTrak. This one will be held on March 30th this month at 3 p.m. GMT. We will also be running a session on the 13th of April in the same time slot. This one will be going over how to install and correctly use the glass cutting kit for the SteelTrak. With these events and sessions, we just want to make sure that you're aware that we are posting consistently on social media, all our social media channels, with reminders, just to make sure you keep up to date with what we're covering and the dates and times that we'll be posting. If you do have any suggestions or any ideas of what you would like to see, then make sure that you are putting those in either the chat today, or we will be posting this video later on our YouTube channel, so you can use the comment section there to be posting any suggestions there. Apart from that, you could always be putting them on any of our Instagram posts or Facebook posts. So wherever you find yourself mostly watching our content, any ideas you have around that, do make sure you're putting those in.
Thank you, Curtis. So once you have managed to super glue all of your corners,
We do have one question.
Oh, okay.
What is the activation spray used for?
The activation spray is used to quicken the rapidity of adhering the super glue to the surface. So it just gives you that extra bit of ability, which is why you have to be very quick with your fingers so you don't glue them there as well. Yeah. Anything else?
Nothing else at the moment.
So once you have completed your corners, you will end up with a sign tray looking like this. Now, the great thing about sign trays is the fact that you can use you can manufacture different sizes, so you can do oblong, rectangular ones, and you can also produce square ones. So here's the square one that I did earlier. So they are quite effective and they look rather good. I hope you have enjoyed the session and that it's been a logical process of how to manufacture a sign tray with the Keencut V-grooving tool and the SteelTrak itself. Anything else, Curtis?
So again, we will be posting this on our YouTube later, but if you have any questions now that you want quickly answered, then again, pop them in the chat. There's about a 10-second delay, so as we are finishing up, I'd put them in sooner rather than later. But apart from that, any feedback you have on these sessions would be great for us, just so we can make sure we're improving them, and hopefully the next one and the one after that will be even better for you. But apart from that, that's all from us, and we hope to see you next time.
Thank you. So as Curtis said, if you do have any questions, you can always contact us here at Keencut. You can find information on our website at keencut.com. You can also find us on all our social media channels. We're on LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, and what am I missing?
Twitter.
That's the one. Yes. And all the videos that we do are housed on our Keencut YouTube channel. So this one will be housed up there as well as the calibrating, the V-groover that I mentioned earlier. And there's lots of different little how-to videos up there. If you do have any suggestions for subjects or topics that you would like us to cover, please do let us know. In the meantime, in 2 weeks' time, on the 30th of March, at 3 p.m. GMT, I will be running through a session on how to correctly score and snap acrylic on the Keencut products. If there is nothing further?
Nothing else, no other questions. I think we're all good to wrap up.
Great. So thank you very much for your company. I have certainly enjoyed doing this. Wherever you are located in the world, I wish you a very happy day. Many thanks. Bye-bye.
Bye, guys.